guys, today's video is a one brand tutorial with e.l.f. products. e.l.f. is a very affordable makeup line that is misconceived to be of a lower quality due to their prices. But just like any brand, it has its hits and misses, so let's get started. I'm priming my face with the Poreless Face Primer to fill in my pores. This primer has a silicone feel and a tea tree oil scent. For foundation today, I'll be using the Flawless Finish Foundation in Buff with the e.l.f. Small Stippling Brush. This foundation is oil-free and has an SPF of 15. It can definitely be built up to a medium coverage and it sets to a matte finish, and I think it looks very natural on the skin. And I'm going to apply a little more to the areas that need a little bit more coverage. Now for highlighting, I'll be using the Tone Correcting Concealer in Honey along with the e.l.f. Studio Flawless Concealer Brush. However, this is the only e.l.f. concealer that I own, and it's only about one shade lighter than my skin tone, which I typically use a concealer that has a yellow undertone and that is about 2 to 3 shades lighter than I am, but I'm gonna make this work. And I'm just going to blend this concealer out. It is quite liquidy and it has a sheer coverage. And to set this under eye concealer, I'll be using the e.l.f. Translucent Mattifying Powder and Corrective along with that same concealer brush. It is a yellow-based setting powder, and it's just such a great product, and you just can't beat the price. Now, to set my foundation, I'll be using the e.l.f. Clarifying Pressed Powder in Spice. This little powder is only $1, and it works like a charm. I'm going to use the little powder puff to press it into my skin, and then I'll go over it with the e.l.f. Kabuki Brush. Also, this powder has salicylic acid in it to help treat acne and to help prevent new acne blemishes. So that's awesome. Moving on to contouring. I'll be using the e.l.f. Contouring Blush and Bronzer Duo in St. Lucia. This duo is definitely a holy grail product for me because the bronzer is absolutely beautiful. It does have a sheen to it, but nothing too dramatic. Now, this e.l.f. Essentials bronzing blush I'm using is definitely a miss. I actually liked it at first. However, after I washed it, the hair started falling out and it never went back to its natural shape. So, for the blush, I'll be using the blush in the duo along with the e.l.f. Studio Blush Brush. I do like this brush. However, the blush is very natural and I love it, but it's just not showing up well on camera. But in person, it's a pinky coral with a bit of a sheen. And then I'm gonna take that Kabuki brush and just blend away any harsh lines. Now for eyebrows, I'll be using the e.l.f. Eyebrow Kit in Dark. This is a great product and I'll only be using the dark brown wax to shape my brows with the little angled brush that it comes with. This product is easier to use with a normal size brush, but I don't have an e.l.f. one, so I'm just going to use this one. And I'm loving my brows. Now to get started with eyeshadow, I'm going to use the e.l.f. Eyelid Primer. You simply can't go wrong with this product. Then I'm going to use the bronzer from the St. Lucia Duo and a dome-shaped blending brush from e.l.f. and apply it all throughout my crease. And I'm going to take it up a little bit on the brow bone. This color is going to serve as a transition color. Then I'm going to use the e.l.f. Prism Eyeshadow Palette in Naked. OMG, all of these colors are gorgeous, buttery, and very, very pigmented. Now I'm going to take the brown copper color and pack it onto the inner and outer corner with an e.l.f. shader brush. The shade is stunning. Now I'm going to apply an e.l.f. cream shadow in Soiree, which is a metallic rose mauve color, to the center of the eyelid. Now this color is sandwiched in and creates a beautiful pop of color against this copper shade. And I'm going to touch up the inner and outer corner and blend out any harsh lines. Now going back to the Prism palette, I'm going to take the creamy beige color and apply it to the brow bone. And now using the gold shadow to highlight my inner tear ducts just to open up the eyes. And then going back to that copper color to bring some color to my lower lash line and smudging it out. Okay, after lashes are curled, I'll be using the e.l.f. Lengthening and Defining Mascara. I feel like the formula is good, but the wand clumps up the mascara and it's quite messy, but it definitely lengthens. So I forgot about eyeliner and here we go. Using the e.l.f. Liquid Liner in Black, I'll be creating a thick line and a wing. This literally is one of my favorite products. And using the Dramatic False Lash Kit, I'll apply falsies. And bam! They are quite dramatic. And a little lipstick. I'll be using two essential lipsticks in Nostalgic and Fantasy to create a nude for my skin tone. These lippies are very silky and quite moisturizing. I just really don't care for the colors that I have in particular, but I do have a red in Fearless and it's gorgeous. And now for a little highlight using the Prism palette in the light rose gold shade. I'll apply it to my cheeks and my cupid's bow. Okay, we can't forget to set this beautiful makeup, so I'm using the e.l.f. Makeup Mist and Set. And this one was a brand new one, and I wasn't prepared for the fierceness to come out. And that's a wrap, my friends. All e.l.f. products, glamorous and affordable. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!